Now, in the continuation of Banker's algorithm or deadlock avoidance algorithm, we'll try to solve some of the questions so that we can fully understand the Banker's algorithm. And with that, we can do some practice. So we are going to practice some gate questions. So this is the gate question that came. This question says that a single processor system. So we have a system with single processor. There are three type of resources, X, Y, and Z, which are shared by three processors, right? So there are different processes that are available. X, Y, and Z are the resources that is there, and the instances are there. So there are five units of each resource type. So what it is saying that there are resources which is of type X, Y, and Z, and we are having a uniprocessor system, means one process at a time will execute. So what is the max resource that is available? So in the data structure, we know that it is the system max, right? So what is the system max here? So the system max here is, in the question it is written, the system max is for X, Y, and Z are 5, 5, and 5. See, it is written. There are 5 units of each resource type in the system. So 5, 5, 5 are the resources which are there. Consider the following scenario. This scenario we have to consider, where the column allocation denotes the number of unit of each resource type allocated to each processes, and the column request denote the number of unit of each resource type requested by a process in order to complete the execution. Which is these process? Okay, so the question is, which of these process will finish last? So we'll find out the sequence, and what are the process that is coming into the last will be the answer for us. Okay. So here it is given allocated, here it is given request, right? So allocation is already allocated. This is the request that is done by the process after the allocation. What is our task? Our task is to find out the sequence that is called safe sequence. Now here, let's calculate the available. So from the resource X, Y, and Z, what are available? That is our lookout. Now I have allocated 1, 2, and 2 instances, and maximum is 5. So what is available? For X it is 0. 2, 0, 2 means 4. Max is 5. 1 is available. 1, 1, 1, it is 3. 5 is max. So 3 is available. So this is my available, which is 0, 1, 3 is my available. Now with this available, which is 0, 1, 3, can I fulfill any of the requests? Now let's go for P0. It required 1, 0, 3. Can I fulfill? It is 0, but it required 1. I cannot fulfill, right? So P0 cannot be fulfilled. Now go for P1. Can I fulfill P1? It required 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. Yes, I can fulfill. Why? Because we have 0 instance of X. It doesn't require anything, any instance of X. For Y, it required 1. I have 1. For Z, it required 2. I have 3. So I can proceed with P1. So I can proceed with P1. So once I am proceeding with P1, my available will be changed to, what is my available right now is 0, 1, 3. After executing P1, P1 will release its allocated. This is 2, 0, 1. And the available will be 4, 1, and 2. This is my available. So with the help of current available, that is 2, 1 and 4, can I fulfill the next one, which is P2? Can I fulfill the P2? 1, 2, 0. 1, it is fulfilled. 2 cannot be fulfilled because I have only one instance. It required two instances. So P2 cannot go. Can I go for P1? It required 1, 0, 3. 1, 0, 3. Yes, I can fulfill because we have 2. It required 1 only. We have 1. It required 0. We have 4. It required 3. I can fulfill it. So when I go for P0, P0 after execution, P0 will release its allocated. Its allocated is 1 to 1. So my available will be right now updated as 335. 335 is my available. So with the help of current available, can I fulfill the request of P2? 1, 2, 0. 1, 2, 0. Yes, I can fulfill. 3, 3, 5 is left. So 1, 2, 0, I can fulfill. Now the next one will be P2. So after executing P2, it will release its resource, that is 2, 2. Okay, there is some. Is there any issue here? Here it is 3. Yes. So 3 is here now. So we have 2 left. So previously it was 2 left. Why? Because 3 is allocated. 5 is max. I'll get 2. So with the help of 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, I can fulfill the request of P1. It will be right now 2. After releasing the resource 2, 0, 1, I'll get, instead of 4, I'll get 3. 3 plus 1, I'll get 4. And 2 to 1 for P2, 2 to 1 is allocated, that will be released. I'll get 5, 5 and 5, which is a maximum. So 5, 5, 5 I'll get after that. So there was a mistake in the very beginning, but sequence will be the same. Okay. So my save sequence is P1, P0, P2. Who is executing at last? P2 is executing at last. This is my answer. Okay. Now let's go for the other question. The next question is, suppose there are 4 processes, which is P1, P2, P3, P4, with 12 instances of a resource R in the system. So what is a max? System max. So the system max here for the resource is 12. We have only one resource, okay, with the 12 instances of R. So this is my R resource. The max need of each process and current allocation are given below. So this is the max need, this is the current allocation. Which reference to current allocation is system. So it is saying that with reference to the current allocation, is system is safe? This is the question. If so, if the system is safe, then what is the safe sequence? So it is the safe sequence it is giving. Means this is the 4 option. It says that system is not safe. Next 3 options are system is safe. Yes, but this is the sequence. So we have to find out which particular option is correct. So for that, the first thing we have to do is we have to calculate the current need. So maximum need minus allocated current need will get. So for this 8 and 3, we'll get 5 required. 9, 4, we required 5. 5, 2, we required 3. 3, 1, we required 2. Okay. Now what is the available? So I can calculate available. So the available will be allocated is 3 plus 4, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10. What is the maximum? Is 12. What is left? Is 2. So with the help of two resources, which current need I can fulfill? So it is clearly shown like I have to fulfill the request for P4. So P4 is my, I'll write here. Or I write here P4. P4 is my current process, which is going to run first. So when P4 will run, after that it will release its resource, that is 1. I have to add it. So this is my available, which is 3. So with the help of current available, which I can fulfill, this is has been done. Now the next is, yeah, I can fulfill the request of this, which is P3. Now after that it will release the resource, which is of 2, instance of resource R. When it will release it, my available will be 5. Now after the available will be 5, I can go for either P1 or P2. Let's go for P2. Let's go for P2. So P2 will release the resource, that is 4. The total will be 9. With the help of 9, I can fulfill the request of this 5. Once it will release the resource, it will be 3. So the total I'll get here is 12. 9 plus 3, 12. 12 is the maximum one I can get. So what is my save sequence? So I can say that yes. Yes, save sequence is there. But which sequence is correct? So can I executing P1 first? No. Can I executing P4 first? Yes. P4 is first executed, then P3 is executed, then here it is P1, P2. See here, when I have done these two, I can go either with P1 or P2, right? So both are correct. If I have a sequence like P4, P3, after that, because I have 5 available here, after fulfilling the request of these two, so I have 5, I can fulfill the request of either P1 or P2. So if I'll go for P1, next will be P2. If I'm going for P2, the next will be P1. So which option is correct here? So option C is. Now let's go and solve this. This is also very simple. It is saying that consider a system with 12 magnetic tape drive and 3 process by P1, P2, P3. Process P1 require maximum 10 tape drive. Process P2 need as many as 4 tape drive, and P3 may need up to 9. So it is talking about maximum need, which is here. Suppose that at time T1, process P1 is holding, let's say the allocated is 5, P2 is holding 2, and P3 is holding 3 tape. At time T1, system is in this particular time, it is saying that system is in safe state or system it is unsafe state. So let's solve it. What is a max, system max? System max is 12. What is available? So available, this is the allocated, is 5 plus 2 is 7 plus 3, it is 10. 2 is available. Okay. Now what is the current need? Here it is 5, here it is 2, and here it is 6. Now with the help of current available, which one I can fulfill? I can fulfill the P2 first. When I am fulfilling the P2 first, what is allocated is 2. 2 will be released. 4 will be available. Allocated is 2, right? two I am releasing. So 5 is 10, 12, yes, 2 is available. So I am fulfilling the requirement of P2. When P2 will release 2, I'll get 4. With the help of 4, can I fulfill the next 5 or 6? No, I cannot fulfill. Now, what is the answer? The answer is, I am going into the deadlock state? No, I am not going to the deadlock state. So where I am going? Can I go to the unsafe state? I may go to the unsafe state when I am giving the requirement of P1, because the current need of P1 is 5, but what is my available is 4. I cannot fulfill it. So where I'll go? I'll go P1 to wait, or I'll say that P1, you should wait. Can I fulfill the requirement of P3? Because the current is 9, I have given 3, 6 is required. Can I go for that? No. P3 will also wait. P3 will also wait. P2 will execute, P1 and P3 will wait. Okay, it is in the waiting state. Now the question, the answer of the question. Whether it is giving the safe state, whether it is giving the unsafe state, whether it is going to the deadlock, whether it is going to the starvation state. So here, because both are waiting, which one? P1 and P3, both are waiting because the resource is not available. If resource is available and both will wait, I'll go for the starvation, because starvation means if food is there, but I cannot eat, that is starvation. But food is not there, so how can I eat, right? So here the resources is 4, the need is 5, I cannot fulfill, it will not go to the starvation. Can I am going into the deadlock state, means somebody is having that resource and somebody is not leaving it, is fulfilling the necessary condition of deadlock? No, because P1 is yes, you can say that, because P1 is having the allocation is 5 and it required is 5, allocation is 3 and required is 6. So, and the available is 4. So, when they will release it, we can go for the next. So, yes, here, because in the banker's algorithm, I am telling the process to wait. So, it is waiting for that. So always in the banker's or the banker's algorithm, it is giving you the sequence, which is a safe sequence. But if it cannot give you the safe sequence, means your system will be not be in the safe state. So you can go for the unsafe state here, because we doesn't have any deadlocks anymore. Or the four the requirement necessary requirement is not. Now let's go for another question, which is very simple one. Is saying that the maximum resources of the system is 9. So max is 9. This is the max. This is the allocation has been given. So the current allocation is 3, 1 and 3. So what is available? Available will be 2. Now what is the current requirement? So that is the maximum requirement. 3 minus 4, 4 minus 3 is 7, minus 3 is 4, 6 minus 2 will be 5, 5 minus 2 will be 2, 7, 5 minus 3 will be 2. Now the current available is 2, I can fulfill P3, I am fulfilling P3. When P3 will release its allocation, this will be 3, this is 5. Now I can fulfill the requirement of P1 as well as P2. Let's go for P1, and I'll go for P1. This will release the resource, which is we have 6, it required 4. I can fulfill here, it will go to P2. I am taking first, so it will P2 and then P1. So it is releasing the resource, which is 3. So I'll get all my resources, that is 9, and my system will be in a save state. So it is saying save, but deadlock is not possible. Save, no deadlock, yes. Not save, deadlock, not save, not get. So it is a save, no deadlock. This is the correct answer, because I am getting the save sequence, right? Now let's see this question. It says that consider a system with 5 process P0 through P4. 3 resources type, that is R1, R2 and R3 resources type has 10, 7 and 8 instances. Suppose that at time T0, the following snapshot of the system has been taken. Assume that now P1 requesting one additional instances of type R1 and 2 instances of type R3. The state resulting after this allocation will be. So it is saying that whether after this, at this particular scenario, what will be the state after it? Yeah. So the availability is, it is calculated. The max, what is the max? System max. So I'm writing here. System max for R1, R2 and R3 has been given as 10, 7 and 8. This is a system max. What is allocated? So go for 1A. This is 5 and 2 is 7. 7 minus 10 will be 3. It is okay. For B, it is 4, 7, it will be 3. Okay. This is 5 and 6 minus 8, it will be 2. Okay. So this is the state right now. Now, with the help of current available, which one I can fulfill? Okay. So current available is 332. So with the help of 332, which request I can fulfill? This is my current request. So my current request, I can fulfill 222, right? Yeah, I can fulfill 222 means P3. I can go for P3 first. P3 will release its resource, which is 211. It will be 3, 4, and 5, right? With the help of 5, 4, and 3, which one I can fulfill? With the help of 5, 4, and 3, I can fulfill P1 as well as P4. Okay. So let's say I'm going for P1. So for P1, it will be 200. 3, 4, 7. Now with this, which one I can go for? Can I go for P0? So 7, 5, 3, I have maybe 7, 4, 3, I cannot fulfill. 902, I have 723, cannot fulfill. 222, that has been already done. So this is done and this is done. Now can I go for P4? This 4433, 743. Yes, I can go for P4. Let's go for P4. The allocated is 022. 022. What is left is 5, 6, and 7. So with the help of that, which one I can fulfill? So as you can see, I can fulfill this, which is 753, means P0. Now if I'm going for P0, it will release 010. 010. So we have 775. This is the available 775. So now P2, can I fulfill the requirement of P2? So as you can see here, P2 is requiring 902. I am having 775, which cannot be fulfilled, right? So P2 has to wait. Sorry, P2 has to wait. Now what is the answer? Can I get, I am getting the save sequence. The sequence is there, which is a save sequence. but P2 has to wait, right? So can I am in a ready state or safe state or block state or unsafe state?